This is pretty common problem you might encounter if you run a Proxmox server. So you installed OpenMediaVault, True NAS, Unraid, or maybe other network attached storage solution as a virtual machine on your Proxmox, then you created shared folder, you enabled Samba or NFS, and you can keep and access all your files over your home network. So in my case, as you can see, I run OpenMediaVault and I can log on to that. This is its IP address. I usually match the end 202 to the container ID, as you can see. It's easier to remember. And the shared folder, I created mini PC. Note the capital M, capital P and C. And I also enabled Samba protocol, which you can see here. By the way, that guest allowed setting allows you to access that shared folder as either a user or a guest as well. Because I've got a user created, it's called SMB user. But you will be able to access these files, this shared folder, I mean, mini PC, as user or as guest. With that, I can access it from any location in my home network. So then I thought, hey, I can also keep all my pictures, movies, TV shows, music, etc. I can keep everything in that shared folder, then install Plex or Jellyfin on the Proxmox as my media server, so I can watch all of that on my TV or on my phone or any other device in my home network. So that's exactly what I did. I installed, in my case, it's Jellyfin, and it's running as unprivileged container. By the way, that is the way you should have it installed. And only then you installed it all, and you realize when you try to add media library, you then realize this media server has no idea where to find your network folder. It doesn't matter what you put here, believe me, I tried, it will not work for unprivileged containers. This is simply the limitation. You can't choose anything here either, because these are local folders, local on the container, on that Jellyfin container in my case, or it might be Plex container in your case, but they are not here. My movies and shows are on OpenMediaVault shared folder. So the solution to that isn't that complicated. With just few commands, we can make it work. And to fix it, we have to go back to Proxmox, to the node itself. In my case, it's called PVE. And then we have to use that shell utility. And Proxmox will act as a man in the middle for us, kind of. We will have to mount here our network location first. In our case, it's OpenMediaVault, the mini PC folder on OpenMediaVault. And then we will pass it to our Jellyfin container. So first, we have to create some local folder so we can use it as a mount point. So I will maybe go to cd-mnt. That's usually a good start. And I can see it's empty. So I will create a new folder called, I don't know, mini PC, but all lowercase maybe. Just to distinguish, this was the capital M and capital PC on the OpenMediaVault, and it will be all lowercase here locally on Proxmox. Then I have to install common internet file system utility, and I can do that by running apt-get install CIFS-utils. Next, it's time to mount our network location to our local location on Proxmox. So I can use command mount-t, then that CIFS tool, then dash lowercase o, then we have to specify the user on the NAS location, on the network attached storage. So remember, for me it is its SMB user, but also remember that I can access it as a guest as well. So if I go back, I can use user equals SMB user, but what I could also do is just log on as a guest. So that would work as well, but I will change it back to SMB user. Now the remote location, which is /// IP address of my OpenMediaVault, and then the shared folder. On OpenMediaVault it was capital letter. This is my shared folder. This is what I'm referring to. Let's go back to our command. And now what folder I want to mount it locally here on the Proxmox. And I want to use that mini PC folder I've just created in mount folder. So the path is mnt mini PC. That's here locally on the Proxmox. Now just press enter and it asks us for password for that Samba user on OpenMediaVault. So I will type it in and that's the job done. So let's have a look first. This is my mini PC folder. If I cd there, Now, if I run ls-li, I should be able to see its content. And I can. That's basically the same as what we had here in my Ubuntu server. So that's it. You can see I have Jellyfin folder already created with movies and shows, so I can go further even. And these ones with dot are hidden folders or files, so I can't see them. For example, here in Ubuntu, in default view, I can only see the ones that have no dot in front. But it doesn't really matter, it works as expected. And now I just need one more command. And the command is pct, maybe let me clear it first. The command is Proxmox Container Toolkit, which in short is pct. Then it's set. Then the destination container ID. In my case, it's Jellyfin. So that ID is 203 for me, in my case. 203. Obviously might be different for you. And then mount point, it's dash mp 0. 0 if it's your first mount point. For me it is, so I just use mount point 0. And now what we do, we have to provide location of what folder we want to kind of share with that container. And for us it's mnt/mini-pc. Remember, that's the one that I've just created here on Proxmox locally. And then, comma, mp equals / where do you want to place it on your container, on Jellyfin container. Oh, nice, it disappeared. One sec, sorry. I want to place it under shared folder on the container. And now I click enter. Might take a while. Oh, it was quick, actually. Now, if I go to my Jellyfin container, under shared folder on that container, I will find all the content that is locally here on mount mini PC. Whatever I find here on my Proxmox in mini PC, I will find it also there. But remember that this folder, its content, it actually comes from OpenMediaVault. So it's kind of like, it's a bit complicated, I know. Now, one more thing I would do is go to Jellyfin and give it a reboot, so it picks up all the changes correctly. I can see CPU goes up, so it should be up. Let's go here to the dashboard, libraries. Can now add library, content, maybe shows first, folders. Now we are interested in local shared folder. So if I scroll down, we've got shared folder, and it's local here on the Jellyfin now, because Proxmox passed that information to this container. And as you can see, I can see that Jellyfin folder, and I can see shows folder as well. And I can add it correctly now. The fact is, this folder is empty right now, but if I had anything there, it would show me, you know, all the shows that I have available there. But that wasn't the point. I hope that helps, so thank you for watching.